What's up internet, welcome back once again. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com, and today in this SQL tutorial we will learn about another database object called indexes. So let's start the tutorial with a brief intro of indexes in Oracle database. Indexes are database objects which you can create over one or more columns of a table. Creating an index over columns of a table can help you in increasing the performance of data retrieval. Indexes are logically and physically independent of the data. Thus, you can drop and create indexes with no effect on the tables or other indexes. So all application continue to function even after you drop an index. Let's take a look at the syntax. This is syntax for creating a B-tree index. A B-tree index is an order list of values divided into ranges. B-tree index associate a key with row or range of rows as well as provide an excellent retrieval performance for a wide range of queries. Here, in this syntax, between create and index keyword, we have an optional parameter which is unique. If you specify this parameter while creating an index, then your index will ensure that the value of the column over which you have created this index contain unique values and restrict the duplicate column insertion. Next, we have index name, which is user defined, and you can give whatever name you want to your index. Then we have on keyword, and followed by on keyword we have to specify the name of the table along with its column over which you want to define your index. And at the end we have table space clause. This clause is optional, and using it we can specify the name of the table space in which we want to store our index. It's always a good practice to store your indexes in a different table space from your tables for performance reason. Hope syntax is clear now. So let's move ahead and see some examples. For the demonstration, I will use my demo table. This table has two columns, demo ID and demo name, where column demo ID is numeric column and column demo name is capable of handling variable character string. Also, I have already populated this table, although it has few rows, but it will do for now, since we only need it for the demonstration. Next, I will create an index on demo ID column of this table. Let's write the command. Let's close this query result. Okay, let's write the command. If you want to make this index a unique index, then you can add unique keyword in between create and index. Let's execute. Unique index created. As we have created a unique index over demo ID column, that means the value which you will insert in this column must be unique. Let's try inserting a row in this table and see what happens if we insert any duplicate value. Let's execute. One row inserted. Now let's try inserting the same value once again and see what happens. We got this error saying unique constraint violated. See, that's how we can create an index or say unique index. Now let's move ahead and see another type of index, which is function based index. Similar to the B-tree index, we can also create a function based index. A function based index computes the value of a function or expression involving one or more columns and store it in the index. Function based index are efficient for evaluating statements that contain function in their where clause. The database only uses the function based index when the function is included in a query. Let's see how to create a function based index. Suppose we have this query. Let me close this script output. Okay, here in this query we have used upper function in where clause. An index can be created over this upper function in order to improve the performance of this query. So when the function based index is included in your query, then it is used by the database. Let's write the query and see how to create a function based index. Let's execute. Index created. That's how we can create a function based index. Hope you enjoyed this video and learned how to create a B-tree index and function based index. Please hit the like button if you find this video useful. Also subscribe for more interesting videos on Oracle database. I will be back soon with another informative tutorial. Till then, take care guys. This is Manish from Rebellion Rider.